Let me introduce you now to Pastor Joseph Tolton.
So instead of worrying about where marriage equality is going, I think that the church, more broadly speaking, has got to take a look at this tremendous disconnect that your traditional Christianity has with millennials. If we don't reach young millennials and connect with their essence and hunger for real spirituality and not religion, we will lose that generation.
Pastor Tolton, does this mean you're accepting of a gay lifestyle, or just you're not turning people away? Which is side of the coin do you fall on?
I actually embrace both. I believe that there is nothing about same-sex love that is on a collision course with the mind of God or the scriptures. And I fully embrace all people as being worthy of the love of God and worthy of being celebrated as God has made them in their individual uniqueness.
I want to talk to you not only about coming out as a gay man, but coming out as a man of conviction, as a man
yes.
of Christ. Had to be a difficult time.
Absolutely, it was. But I've always known who I was. And I remember being a child at about the age of 9 or 10 and feeling this call to ministry, but also very much knowing that I was a same gender loving man. So it's been a difficult road, but I'm so glad to be free, and I'm so glad to be living my truth.
I think that that is really overstated, in that certainly in the African context, there's nothing cool about being ejected from your family. There's nothing cool about living under the threat of violence. There's nothing cool about being excluded and targeted and marginalized. There's nothing cool about that.
But Sodom had no care for the poor. Sodom could not embrace those that were marginalized, strangers, or different. To be a Sodomite is to reject those that are different.
We reject LGBTI people because there's a part of ourselves that we reject. All we do is mirror each other. And so when we're merciful and compassionate and loving to ourselves, we will be merciful, compassionate, and loving to others.